Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, internet's busiest music nerd and all that. And it's time for a review of the new Don Toliver record, Life of a Don. This is a brand new LP from Houston's own Don Toliver, who's been slowly and successfully building up his name over the past several years, not just as a member of Travis Scott's Jack Boys, but also through a series of high-profile features with the likes of Nav, Eminem, Nas, Baby Keem. He also hit a peak last year when he dropped his studio debut, Heaven or Hell, which mostly felt like Toliver trying to extend the appeal of his feature and hook appearances out into a full-length album. One that did have highlights, but was still kind of short in one note. But Life of a Don, on the other hand, seems like a genuine attempt to define Toliver as a standalone artist, even going easy on the features as not to distract too much from him vocally. And I do respect it. Toliver really does try to carry the vast majority of this record on his own, but he still falls way short of actually doing that, in fact, much shorter than I could have anticipated. See, Heaven or Hell, for all of its shortcomings, still did showcase some good vocal performances where Toliver leaned boldly into his unique and instantly recognizable vocal timbre. And for whatever reason, those strong and fiery performances are a rare find on the 16 tracks here. I mean, generally, this is a pretty chill, vibe-heavy LP, and maybe Toliver wanted to mostly match that energy. Whatever his reasoning was, Life of a Don just hits with one super subdued song, vocal, and beat after another with not really much to break it up. I guess in a way I do respect the record for picking an idea and sticking with it being consistent, as musically and aesthetically, the instrumentals on this thing hang pretty squarely within the sonic universe that Travis Scott has already established through his past three records and Jack Boys. And Toliver seems happy to take that sound and expand it in more of an R&B friendly direction, occasionally indulging in very spacey, repetitive, introspective cuts a la Drake, swanging on Westheimer, for example. And as an added bonus, there's quite a bit of synth and guitar work on this project from the great Mike Dean, which provides some great melodic embellishments to this record, some cool retro-futuristic colors. But even with all this added support, and there is a really dense list of producers and co-writers on this project, it just doesn't make up for the fact that Don Toliver isn't really pushing it far enough vocally or lyrically. For the whole first leg of this LP, be it Escape or Five Times, we're hit with a lot of very syrupy, psychedelic trap, which is a fine setting. It's a pretty sound, nothing wrong with it, but Toliver vocally doesn't do much on top. To me, his vocal lines on this record are more likely to sedate than seduce. The song Drugs and Hella Melodies, for example, with Caliuchis, even though this track has some pretty raunchy lyrics here and there, and obviously that Caliuchis feature, the whole thing sounds like the soundtrack to boring sex. It's too stiff, it's too washed out, it's too lifeless. Meanwhile, the track Way Bigger is meek in its approach to songwriting. It feels like it's just stuck on intro, can't progress past the first idea it brings to the table. Even massive assists from Travis Scott on You or Flocky Flocky come off really mild, especially when you consider them in context with Toliver's and Travis's past crossovers. I don't think we get a legit catchy vocal on this record until the song What You Need, but again, the production on that track is so washed out and there's so much sonic clashing going on in the mix, the song's positive qualities are sort of drowned out. And the beats, even though up until this point they're very much, for me, the selling point of the record, even they take a nosedive around the second half. 2 AM, for example, the dry and stiff claps and stumbling kicks don't really inspire much of a groove. And I'm kind of surprised by the track Get Throwed. Not only does this have some of Toliver's worst vocal lines on the entire LP, what is it, got a Spanish bitch on me like a poncho? Okay, buddy. But I was shocked to see Mustard was credited on the beat here, because this sounds like something you'd hear if you typed Mustard type beat into YouTube. It's sort of like a pale, dry, unseasoned version of the original. Company Part 2 sees Toliver vocally meandering in a lot of atmosphere over a lot of synths without much in the way of any progression or structure. Feels like something he would kind of throw down casually in the studio and then go back to and do something more thorough with later, like a demo, you know? I will also say Baby Keem is a sight for bored ears when he pops up on Outer Space, but even he is not enough to save this awkwardly structured track with a totally nonsensical beat switch. And then the last leg actually provides some decent cuts here. Crossfaded, for example, has one of the most impassioned, cute, and endearing vocal performances from Tolliver on the entire record. Pretty animated, I'm just left wondering, even though it is enjoyable, where was this energy on the rest of the LP? Bogus as well sees Tolliver vocally sounding a bit more locked in, where on the last two tracks of this record and from front to back, on two songs back to back, you are finally sounding awake. Yeah, this record overall is just a really massive letdown. Granted, there's a lot of good production here and there is a lot of talent supporting this thing on the instrumentals, on the writing. And with his last LP, Tolliver left many fans with the impression that he was going to have a lot of potential going forward. But most of the time on Life of a Don, he failed to even meet that level of songwriting and vocal performance. It's as if he spent 40 minutes of this thing warming up as opposed to just being ready to play. Yeah, I'm feeling a strong 4 to a light 5 on this thing. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Don Tolliver, forever.